access the recruiter system, you would need to go to banner.ysu.edu. When you come to this page, you would click on Recruiter. Here you can see that the YSU recruiter has production recruiter as well as test recruiter. Since we're still testing, we still have this here, which will be removed shortly. So since I am doing a training video, I will click under the training recruiter CRM admin console. However, when you log into the system, you will click CRM admin console, which is under production recruiter. This will bring you to the home page of the recruiter system that would include your dashboards. Your dashboards include your charts and your reports, and it also includes your activities. Your activities or tasks would include your graduate file for review, your supplemental items for that applicant, any emails sent to the student, any kind of communication relevant to the application process will be under your activities. And it would also include your task for your review process. Your charts and your reports are basically your student data, which is analyzed. If you look at the prospects by status chart, you can see the number of students who have submitted an application, number of students who have completed an application, and the number of students who've inquired about the program. This is only a test site, so there are few numbers, but in a live site, you're gonna have more numbers over here. You can also access student data from your charts. So if you click on viewing the records, you will be able to see who the students are who've applied to the program, how many have submitted. You get their full name. You can see their relationship type as to which level they are in. You can see their desirability rating, which is 80%. You can see their probability rating. And these ratings would change as they keep sending in documents towards the application process, and as the application gets closer to completion, these figures would change. You can also view their contact information so that you can successfully email them as needed. You can send them reminder emails so that they do not miss their deadlines. You can even communicate with them regarding more information regarding the program. And you can communicate with the student basically even before the application process has been completed. If you click on a student profile, on the full name of the student, you will be able to access the student profile. You would need to click on these tabs for it to refresh and pull up the screens. So this is the profile of this particular applicant. You get their email information, you know the program they registered for, the semester they're looking at, and you can also see any kind of recent activity regarding the application. So this applicant, if you see, is a prospect and has sent an inquiry, however, has not really started the application process. If you close this window, you will come back to your dashboards. Your activities can be actually accessed from the dashboards as well as your activities on the left-hand side. However, before I go there, I want to show you one more chart. This would be the rating of your program versus other departmental programs. So this just gives you like the prospects with applications by academic program of interest, so you would know exactly where your program would stand compared to the other programs offered. So let's go back to activities. You can access your tasks and activities from your dashboards area, which is this area on the dashboards, or you can also access it from your workplace, and below dashboards is activities tab. Click on the activities and you would be able to see all your tasks. As I mentioned earlier, it would include your student, any kind of communication with the student, like emails sent. It would include supplemental items for the student, and it also include your file for review. To access your graduate file for review, you would need to select the checkbox and then click on Edit on the top ribbon. This would open up a screen which is called Graduate File for Your Review. To go further into the application process, you would need to click on Regarding. Regarding is just simply a student number which the system creates, similar to how the banner system creates a YSU banner ID for the student. Recruiter creates this number for each student, and this number will change when the student application is submitted to the ERP system. If you click on this number, you will be able to access the application folder. The application folder is just like your paper application. It would include your cover page, your supplemental items, your completed recommendations, your advisor information, your folder management, and your notes. So let's quickly look at each one of them individually. This is your cover page. You would need to click on it a couple of times for it to load up the screen. So this is your cover page, which includes your test scores, and you can access it right on the top. Other information regarding the student. And then you go to the supplemental items. The supplemental items would include all the required documents for the application process. If you see the essay, you have the GRE scores, your letters of recommendation, your resume, and your transcripts. You can click on a supplemental item and you would be able to save it on your desktop, or you can open it and take a printout. So let's see what happens when we open it in a Word document. This is just dummy copy for testing purposes, and you can save it. You can save it, you can print it to share it with other people in the department or your search committee. You can also view your completed recommendations. These are the completed letters of recommendation for the student. Very similar to the paper application. Here you have information regarding your advisor, your primary advisor, and your secondary advisor. And this is your folder management, which would include the GPA scores of the student. Please note that the application folder cannot be edited or deleted. However, you can put your comments and your remarks regarding the application under the notes section. So you can actually put in any kind of remarks or comments in the notes section. This can be accessed by other people who are looking at this application. For instance, the College of Graduate Studies, or maybe the college dean, or somebody else reviewing this application folder will be able to see your comments and remarks placed in the notes section. So you can actually put your comments here, and then you can click on Done to save it. So this brings you to this screen where you can see who has put the remarks, what time they've put it, and what the remarks are. Once you've reviewed the entire application folder, you can click on Open Review. Before we go to Open Review, I would also like to mention that the application folder can be printed. So if you click on Print Application Folder, you will be able to print this application. You can select as to which part of the application you would like to be printed. If you want everything to be printed, or you just want certain components of this application folder to be printed. So you do have the option to print your application folder. Now, once you've completed reviewing your application folder, you can click on Open Review. You will find Open Review on your top ribbon